The Honourable Member for Edmonton-Riverbend.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It's my pleasure to speak today in support of the member of Calgary Confederation's private member's bill to streamline organ donation. I want to thank the member for his work on the bill, as well as his hard work in helping to create the organ donation registry in our home province of Alberta, when we both served in the provincial legislature together. Mr. Speaker, I had the opportunity to both speak to his provincial bill and now to the federal bill, hoping that we can see similar results in passing both of those. Almost every Canadian has heard about someone whose life was impacted by organ donation, whether in the media or through personal connections. The organ donation of one person can save up to 8 people, and a tissue donation can impact more than 70 people. Of course, even more people than that are impacted because families get to keep their loved ones alive longer because of donation. However, only a quarter of Canadians are registered to donate. Our organ donation rate is among the lowest in the world. Currently, almost 5,000 Canadians are waiting for a transplant, and their lives depend on it. Sadly, about 260 Canadians lose their lives every year while waiting for a transplant that sadly never happens. That is about 5 deaths per week, or 1 death about every 30 hours. That could be saved if they had a viable donor. 90% of Canadians say that they support organ and tissue donation. However, in practice, less than 20% have actually made plans to and registered to donate. In the past 10 years, the number of deceased organ donors has gone up by 42%. The number of people needing a transplant has also gone up in that time. Therefore, a more effective method is needed in order to increase the size of the organ donor base in Canada. The proposal from the member for Calgary Confederation is so simple yet so smart. Implementing it could mean a huge increase in the number of organ donations in Canada, and my friend is proposing to add an option on the tax revenue forms where people can declare whether they would like to register to be an organ or tissue donor. If they check yes, their names and information are given to the person's provincial government and added to an organ donor database. Mr. Speaker, almost every Canadian fills out these forms annually. Making registration for organ and tissue donors easier will save more lives. It will be the same process for everyone, no matter what province they live in. There is no need to create a new computer and database systems because the existing system we have can do that job. This method will reach the most potential donors at the lowest cost. This will also help identify organ donors when someone dies outside of their province of residence. With the new system the member for Calgary Confederation is proposing, it will be more efficient to identify donors, resulting in more lives being saved. Earlier this year, our country had a horrible tragedy when 15 young men and one young woman from the Humboldt Broncos hockey team died after a bus crash. After that tragedy, there was a spike in the number of people who signed up to become organ donors. I wish it didn't take such an unfortunate accident to encourage people to become organ donors. However, I'm glad to see organ donation on the rise. The current process to register to become an organ donor in my province of Alberta involves going online to put your name on the organ donation registry. This was something that was spearheaded by the member for Calgary Confederation while he was a member of the Legislative Assembly, and it's so great to see him work so hard to continue this good work on a national scale here in Parliament. It's so important to have the registry, and the number of organ donors has risen since it was implemented in 2013, but it's just not front of mind for most people. With so many things going on in our lives, we don't always remember to complete this type of task. Bringing the option of organ donation right to Canadians instead of waiting for Canadians to come to a website will no doubt result in an increase in the number of registered donors in Canada. Currently, the only proactive approach by governments is to register Canadians via the driver's license registration process. However, the percentage of Canadians with a driver's license is dropping in every age category. While young Canadians are future donors, they have the healthiest organs. Less than 70% of 19-year-olds obtain a driver's license. This indicates a 20% drop from the previous generation. In Canada, only 1,600 people are added to the organ transplant waiting lists each and every year. On top of that, there's also a limited time in which organs can be viable for transplant to matching donor on the waiting list after death, typically within less than a day. With a continuous decline in driver's license registrations, Bill C-316 is a sensible solution to gather more donors, decrease the number of Canadians' patients on donation wait lists, and ultimately save more lives. Kidney donations are the most common organ transplant in Canada, followed by the liver, lungs, and heart. A study done by the Canadian Blood Services examining organ transplants between 2006 and 2015 found that transplants benefit both patients and provincial health services. According to the study, kidney transplantation is the best therapy for patients with end-stage kidney disease. Compared to dialysis, it can more than double a patient's life expectancy, although the data in this section speaks primarily to the benefits of kidney transplantation. Other types of transplantations, such as lung, heart, and liver, are also beneficial. Mr. Speaker, the same study found that transplants can save governments money because of reduced hospital stays. It is estimated that the province of Ontario alone already loses approximately $100 million every year to support the care of those on the organ donation waiting list for a kidney. The study states liver, heart, and lung transplants may also reduce costs for government. Although there is limited information on the cost avoidance associated with the transplantation of organs than kidneys, a UK report states there is some evidence that the care of patients with life-threatening organ failure may involve many days or weeks in hospital care, including significant time in intensive care, which is also very expensive, that would be avoided if transplantation had taken place. It's evident that organ and tissue donation benefit patients, families, and taxpayers because of decreased healthcare costs. However, other countries are far ahead of Canada in terms of successful transplants. Mr. Speaker, as I said earlier, Canada has a low organ donation rate. Figures from 2015 show that only 1% of Canadians who die in hospital donate their organs. We lag behind many other countries, including the United States, in registered donors. In Europe, many countries have opt-out organ donation systems. This means that all citizens are automatically registered as organ donors and have to deregister themselves if they do not wish to be a donor. Because of this system, Spain leads the world in the number of registered donors. I think the system proposed by the member for Calgary Confederation is a happy medium. It will reach almost all Canadians without being heavy-handed. Canadians don't want the government telling them what to do. With our tax form system, Canadians can decide for themselves what they want to happen to their bodies. This will be a most convenient system for potential donors. Additionally, it's practically free to implement because it utilizes existing documents. This system is economical for taxpayers and will ultimately help to save more lives. Many of us don't like to think about it, but we never know when or if we'll need an organ donation. Our lives could change in an instant. Many families have been put in a position where they have to wait for life-saving organs or tissue to become available. This is an incredibly nerve-wracking wait. Often families don't know whether the donations will come on time. In Edmonton right now, a young girl from Okotoks is waiting to receive a number of life-saving organs. Thousands of other Canadians are in the exact same situation. The wait is agonizing for these families and are like us as parliamentarians to do everything we can to decrease the number of families in this situation. Mr. Speaker, Bill C-316 would be a great amendment to the Canada Revenue Agency Act. As I've said, it will reach more Canadians, increase the number of donors, save taxpayers' money, and ultimately save more lives. This is a sensible solution to our problem of low donor numbers. This is a very straightforward private member's bill, and I'm pleased to support it today. I urge all members of this House to continue to consider supporting Bill C-316. I want to thank my friend, the member for Calgary Confederation, for bringing this bill forward. I also want to thank him for all the work he's done on organ donation, both here and in Alberta. He was instrumental to bringing in Alberta's organ donation registry and has stayed true to his word to continue to fight for strong organ donation access right here in Parliament. I hope the next time we all do our taxes, we see the option of becoming an organ donor right there on the forms. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for the opportunity to speak to Bill C-316 today.